Photoshop is dead. That's what everyone is saying over the internet after using Google's new image model, which is called Nano Banana. It's a funny name though, but it is really powerful. I have used it for a few of the prompts, few of the images here and there, and it has done a really great job. And in this video, I'm going to show you guys how you can use that using aistudio.google.com and how you can make most of it. And we will also be doing tests in this video and seeing if actually Photoshop is that. Personally, I don't believe that it's a true, because Photoshop is a really in-depth image editing tool. And if a big marketing company or a big company looking for a really pixel perfect marketing material, then this tool is not actually gonna work. And I think Photoshop is still useful, but a lot of the basic level image editing is actually that. So let's jump onto the screen where I'll show you guys how to use Nano Banana, the latest Google AI image tool. So let's start it. Okay guys, so that is our aistudio.google.com. You will just log into your Gmail account and go to aistudio.google.com, and here you will find Try Nano Banana. I don't know if you have received the access to this, but I have the access received, so I'm gonna show you guys how you can use that. And first use case is, let's do a little basic task from it. So you might have seen a lot of Fiverr jigs back in 5 years ago to remove the background from the picture. And there were also some Upwork jobs, which I have seen back in 5 years ago, to remove the background of like 100 images or 200 images. But now you can do that with this AI tool really fast and with really high quality. Now that is the image which I'm going to use. So this is the image where I'll remove the background. And if I zoom into this picture, and if you take a look at the hairs, there's a lot of detail required in order to remove the background, right? And here you can see the belt area, right? So it is a little hard to remove the background if you do that manually from the Photoshop. Obviously, I agree that Photoshop also has now tool to remove the background, but I'm just curious about finding out that how good Nano Banana is at the moment, right? So let's try finding out. I'm gonna upload this picture to my Nano Banana model. Let's do that by this, dragging and dropping the image. There you go. And I am just going to say remove background from this picture to compare the result, right? And see how it works. And here you go. You have now plain white background on the image. And if I open up the image, you can see that the quality is really high. The image quality is high. So that is the original image. And that is the one which is given to us from Nano Banana, right? So really awesome result in the background removal. Now let's do another test and try merging these four pictures and create a new picture, right? So I'm gonna give these four different objects, which is an umbrella and a car and a dog and this female picture. I'm gonna give it to the Nano Banana and see what other results we're gonna get. So let's close this down and open up a new prompt. I'm gonna click on chat again, click on try Nano Banana. Make sure you have Nano Banana showing up here. And I'm going to now upload these four images one by one. So let's do this. Perfect. Now, let's give it a prompt. Let's please create a new image using all of the four images I have attached. I mean, it's the basic level prompting anyone can do. It's just a natural language where I'm saying, please create a new image using all of the four images I have attached, right? Everyone can do that. So let's see what other outcomes we're going to get. So click on run and see what are we going to get. Take a look at that. Okay, so we have the background, we have the umbrella. Take a look at the image. Nice. You can see the character consistency. Okay, it did added a mishap. The female has three hands. The dog is fine. This dog is the same. The car is the same. The background is same. But the female has three hands. So what I'm going to do, I'll just say, please fix the female hand on this picture. Let's see what we get now. Okay, we have another result and still the same issue. So again, I told you guys that Photoshop is not actually dead, but you can see that a lot of stuff has been done really accurately, like the umbrella, the dog and the stuff. Obviously we will be needing to prompt a lot, but we can get the basic job done really easily with the text prompt with the natural language. So it is really powerful. Now, one other thing I want to show in the latest Google AI models is this build thing. So if you go to aistudio.google.com and click on build, you have these different apps which are created by Gemini, and these are also using Flash image model, Gemini 2.0 Flash image. The secondary name is Nano Banana, but the actual name is Gemini 2.5 Flash image. So we're going to use this PixShop and use this image to see what we can do, what specific editing we can do. So I'm going to save this image. I'm going to name it result, and I'm going to use the same folder, right? So I've saved the image. Now I'm going to use this PixShop where you can actually click on the object and tell the Google to actually change the object or remove the object or stuff like that. Now let's try it out to see. And this app is actually built with Google Gemini 2.5 coding model, and you can actually deploy it one click if you want. You can simply click on this deploy to cloud run. You can connect the domain name, and this app which is running here is going to be live, and you can use it as a SaaS, add for the payment gateway and start earning money if you want to create a SaaS. So now a day's creating a SaaS is like super fast with this new AI tools that are releasing every single day. So really important to learn all of these new tools, because that's where the opportunity lies. So we have to run with the trend. So let's check out our image. So I'm going to upload the same image. Let's do that. Result. Now let's try to fix the hand from this tool. Here we have different options: retouch, crop, adjust, stuff like that, right? Okay, let's click on this extra hand, this one here, and I'm going to prompt it to remove the hand. So all I have to do is just click on retouch here from this PixShop app, and then click on this extra hand here, and you can see this blue dot. And now I am going to prompt it, please remove this extra hand. Let's see what we get. Click on generate. AI is working its magic. And here you go. You can see that we have an awesome result, which we can check here. We don't have an extra hand, and it looks completely natural. It doesn't look that it's image generated with AI, and it looks completely natural. By the way, Google is adding synth ID to all of the image asset generated via AI. So if you try to use these assets and claim to be it a natural image, it is not going to work, because now Google add a transparent watermark, which is not visible to the eye, but it is recognized by the Google, which is called synth ID. So if you generate images from AI, you'll have to mention it if you are using it for the paid stuff. And if you're submitting it to a marketplace to earn money from it, you'll have to mention that it is generated with AI, because it automatically adds the synth ID to all of the picture generated with the AI. Some other cool filters which we have here. If we click on filters, you can see that we have this anime. And if we click on apply filter, it is going to convert it to an anime picture, which was an ongoing trend when the ChatGPT released it. Now let's see how the anime version of this picture looks like. It didn't change much, does it? Nope. So anime isn't working really well. let's see some other results. I'm going to click on synthwave to see what do we get here. Okay, here's another result of the synthwave, right? That looks cool. Nice. And here we have the option of basically reset it to the original version. We can also compare it. Actually, it is not working. The compare thing is not working on this app. And we have this undo button, which works fine. So if I undo it, it's gonna basically revert the changes which we did. And we also have some other cool apps in the apps section of Gemini, Google AI Studio. Here we have chat with the docs. This is not for Gemini 2.5 flash image. The image one, we have this one. So it is basically going to add a beautiful canvas to your images and creating the past versions from the image. So I'm going to upload the same image here, which we generated. And let's see how the result is coming along. Okay, we can drag and drop this canvas. And here we have different versions of the image which we have given to this. Right. So that's the 1970s version. That's the 1950s version. Right. It's just changed the dress. It looks really awesome. Let's try downloading the image and see how it actually looks. Nice. Not bad. We can see the quality is also good. A little pixelated, but the changing of clothes and everything looks very natural. And we have a lot of different apps, which, so this app is again, basically created with Google Gemini 2.5 code model. And it's just with one prompt. So if you want to add any more feature to this app, you can basically prompt it right from here and then click it here to deploy on cloud. It's that simple. You're just gonna prepare your app and click on deploy to cloud run, and it's going to basically deploy your app to the cloud, and you just need to connect the domain name and your SaaS software as a service is ready to be launched. And it's awesome. Cool. And we have these other apps as well. You can try that out from aistudio.google.com/apps. And that's it for the video. So that's it for the latest Nano Banana image model, which you can use to enhance your image editing skills. If you like the video, make sure to subscribe to the channel and let me know in the comments below for the use cases which you are building up with the Nano Banana. Until next video, have a great day.